Gen Z blurred.
The title itself is very clear that it deals with what is experiential learning and how it will be meaningful, because Gen Z learners' requirement or need is means they are particular about the meaningful learning. Unless and until they don't understand what they are learning, they don't learn. And so I will give a brief introduction about what is Gen Z or Gen Z, Generation Z learner. What are their traits? What are their characteristics? Basically, the children who were born during 1995 to 2012 are come under Gen Z traits or Generation Z learner. They are totally independent learners. They like to study on their own. They are tech savvy. They are mostly inclined towards technology, gadgets, using technology in their life. And based on their characteristics, they are more inclined towards collaborative or engaged kind of learning. They want to learn with each other. And they are socially conscious. Because aajkal ka bachcha har kuch janta hai, sab kuch janta hai, because they are exposed to WhatsApp, they are exposed to they are exposed to television, they are exposed to internet, and they are exposed to all kind of stuff which are they are getting through this internet technology. So they are socially conscious. Bahut kuch jankari unke paas already maujood hai. Based on this, we have categorized or we have drawn some learning preferences of these Gen Z learner. Interactive and engaging. They are more interactive. Unless and until they don't interact with the content, we interact with the teacher, interact in the classroom, they don't like to study. वो जब तक engage नहीं होंगे class में, वो सीखने की उनकी जो ख्वाहिश है वो नहीं होगी, और वो जो सीखने की जो उनकी capacity है वो enhance नहीं होगी. They are visually oriented. ऐसा नहीं है, they are not passive listeners. They don't just listen to the lectures of teacher. They want to see what they are learning, what they are studying, what kind of the content they are getting. They want everything in the form of video or visual pictures. Then practical and actionable. Whatever they are learning, they want to practice it. This is the preference, learning preferences of Gen Z learners. And quick and bite-sized means they are mostly oriented. This is the era of short, so they want to learn everything in a bit and quickly. So they are, because of their attention span is very small, so they want to learn everything in very short time. These are some limitations of traditional learning. Because of this traditional learning, the Gen Z learner cannot learn based on this traditional learning technique or this traditional learning methodologies. Lack of active involvement, mismatch with the learning styles, limited relevance and motivation, discourage critical thinking, because they have to just listen passively whatever the teacher is demonstrating, teaching, guiding, whatever he is doing. And they feel boredom and bored. Because of that short attention span will be there, and missed opportunity for collaboration, because mostly student has to do what the teacher is asking him to do. What experiential learning is totally based on the Kolb's. Kolb's is a psychologist. He has prepared this cycle which is showing what is experiential learning and how it works. It works basically whenever the child encounter with the concrete experience in his life, कुछ भी जो भी उसके साथ life में experience होता है, concrete experience which he experience. After getting or doing the experience, he move or switch towards the reflective observation. He started reflective thinking on the experience which he has done. जो कुछ उसने किया है, he is started reflective thinking. After continuous reflective thinking, he switched towards abstract conceptualization. It automatically convert the experience based on his particular reflective observation towards the conceptualization that is abstract. After abstract conceptualization, the student moved towards active experimentation. Whatever concrete experience he got after his reflective thinking, he start experimenting on other situations. दिस इज कॉल्ड एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग। एक एक्सपीरियंस होता है, फिर उसके बाद रिफ्लेक्टिव थिंकिंग होती है। उस रिफ्लेक्टिव थिंकिंग की वजह से जो लर्निंग पैदा हो रही है, नई फाइंडिंग जो लर्नर अपने आप से हासिल कर रहा है, दैट ही मूव टूवर्ड्स एक्टिव एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन, दूसरे एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन में वो इस्तेमाल करना शुरू करता है। तो दिस इज द स्टेटमेंट, रोल ऑफ एक्सपीरियंशियल लर्निंग इन एनहैंसिंग मीनिंगफुल लर्निंग अमंग जेन ज़ी लर्नर। दिस इज द टाइप ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंटल लर्निंग। फर्स्ट वन इज रोल प्लेइंग, वेयर द स्टूडेंट प्ले द रोल ऑफ पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन। जो भी एक्सपेरिमेंट करवाया जा रहा है, जो भी प्रॉब्लम है, उस प्रॉब्लम में जो रोल प्ले करना है, when he the child Gen Z learner feel very interesting, very enthusiastic when he start playing the role. Then next one is simulation. Simulation is nothing but providing a situation. No, it is not the actual situation, it is simulated situation, just simulated situation of a jungle, simulated situation of a laboratory or something. Next is project, assigning the project where the students collaboratively learn things and bring the findings of the problems. Next, field trip give them exposure to variety and different kind of things, which make them very communicative and understand the content very thoroughly. Next is internship and apprenticeship.
Moshana, sorry to interrupt you, please. We are running out of time. Please continue.
Yes, sir. What is the benefits of experiential learning for Gen Z learner? The first is it increases the engagement, actively involvement. The students get active involvement in the classroom or the content. They get variety and relevance. Then apart from this, the sense of accomplishment, because they get the project, because they face the problem, they try to solve the problem by themselves, and that leads them to feel the sense of accomplishment. And because of feeling the accomplishment, definitely interest and curiosity arises, and collaboration definitely create the enthusiasm in among the students. मैं कर रहा हूँ, ये कर रहा हूँ, like this. And ownership of learning. मुझे पढ़ना है, मेरे लिए पढ़ना है, मुझे सीखना है, that will increase among the students because of the experiential learning. And deeper understanding the meaning, making meaning, contextualizing, problem solving, and it develops lot of critical thinking among the students. And apart from this, experiential learning, it builds skills. What kind of skills? Skills for future. Their future learning, their future self-development, collaboration, adaptability, innovation, real-world problem solving, and resilience and growth mindset. These are the major important points which I wanted to discuss. And these are the potential obstacles which come whenever the experiential learning provide in the classroom. Mostly it is very difficult for the teacher because of the time paucity, and teacher cannot manage the time, and resources are not accessible, and faculty should be trained. Unless and until the teacher is not trained, he is not able to practice the experiential learning in the classroom. These are the effective integration of EL activities, planning and designing, implementation and addressing the challenges. Last, finally, there are few important areas which can go for the research for exploration, that is impact on diverse learners, long-term benefits, technology roles, and teacher training, comparing outcomes. This is the because of paucity of time, I could not explain thoroughly. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Moshana. Thank you for the presentation here. इस तरह से हम लोगों के लिए भी एक चैलेंजिंग है फॉर द एकेडमिशियंस, दैट हाउ वी विल हैंडल दिस पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन इन दिस डिजिटल एज, बिकॉज़ ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर वेरी एडवांस नाउअडेज़,
यस,
सो इट इज वेरी टफ टास्क टू मैनेज द स्टूडेंट, बिकॉज़ ऑफ इवन अवर टीचर्स हैव देयर computer literacy, but our child, even the teenagers, have very strong knowledge about the tools and technologies. So they are very advanced in these fields. So thanks again, Moshana, Dr. Moshana, ma'am.